In today's session of Harbor Engineering, we will be beginning with the new chapter, that is chapter number 2, Harbor Planning. In the previous session, we have discussed about the introduction to the Harbor Engineering portion, and we discussed a few contents regarding the introduction part. So now let's begin with the important chapter, that is Harbor Planning. So now let us talk about the contents which we will be studying in this chapter. Basically, these are the contents which we will be covering in the overall chapter, but in today's session we will be completing the first content, that is the definition part, and we will be beginning with the harbor components. Rest of the contents I will be discussing step by step, that is session by session. Now this is a very important chapter, harbor planning. The reason behind it is that in this chapter we will be studying the function in short, the use in short, about the various harbor elements, and later on in chapter number 4, which is the chapter having the highest amount of weightage in the harbor engineering portion, we will be studying each and every component in detail. So basically the idea which will be given in this chapter, that is in chapter number 2, regarding the various harbor components is prerequisite for that chapter, and so we should keep our focus while studying all these various elements which I will be teaching step by step, and in this session I will be beginning it and we will be continuing it in the upcoming session. So one must give importance to this chapter. So now let us begin with the first content, that is with a few definitions related to the harbor engineering portion. So let's begin with the definition portion. Now in the introductory session I have already explained the meaning of harbor, but we will be going through it again in this session. So first of all, we need to understand the meaning of the word harbor. So let us understand word by word the meaning. Harbor is a partly enclosed water area. It might also be a fully enclosed water area. Now basically, enclosed means sort of a covered area or a protected area. Partly means that area might be sort of, we can say, a percentage might be sheltered or protected or covered, and fully means that water area is fully protected or fully given shelter or fully covered. So that is a partly enclosed or fully enclosed water area, in short protected water area, which provides safe and suitable accommodation. Now another thing, as I told that it is sort of a protected area, we will learn in the upcoming session what is meaning of protection for a harbor and how is a harbor protected. But as of now, understand that enclosed means sort of a protection, sort of giving a shelter. I will be explaining in detail regarding the meaning of those words at the appropriate time. So next, which provides safe and suitable accommodation, that is it gives sort of space for vessels, that is the ships, ship or boat which are coming at that harbor, who are seeking refuge, that is means those ship which want to have shelter or which want to have sort of a halt while they are making the voyage, that is while they are moving from their origin to destination. If they want to have halt, if they want to have stoppage, if they want to take shelter, then that is the meaning of this term, that is to seek refuge. Supplies, that is if anything has to be supplied or if anything has to be supplied to the ship or from the ship, then the supplies. Refueling, that is the fueling operation for the ship to be carried out can be done at an harbor. Repair work, that is sort of repair or any maintenance work of the ship can be done at the harbor. And loading and unloading of cargo can be done at the harbor itself. So these are the sort of, we can say, various functions or various operations which can be performed at a harbor. So we talked about the specific meaning of the enclosed portion and the various operations such as accommodation, that is giving space to give shelter, supplies, fueling operation, repair or maintenance work, and loading and unloading of cargo. So these are the various activities which are being carried out at an harbor. Next is the word port, which is many a times used as synonym for harbor, but there is a marginal difference between port and harbor. So a port is a harbor where marine terminal facilities are provided. So all those activities all those operations which are being carried out at an harbor are all included in a port, but it has additional facility of marine terminal facility. So that is the additional portion, that is the provision of marine terminal facilities exist in port, which was not in the case of a harbor. So we can say that harbor is a subset of a port. The facilities, that is the marine terminal facilities which are mentioned, includes pier or wharves. Now all these words, that is pier or wharves, transit shed or warehouse, all these elements of harbor, we will be studying each and every element in detail in this portion. So you will be getting aware about all these terms at the specific time, that is whenever the need is to go in detail, we will be learning in that chapter. And right now we will be only learning the meaning in short. So whenever we are discussing in chapter 4, at that time we will be learning all these elements in detail, and right now we will be only studying the functions of it in short. So the marine terminal facilities which we were talking about, firstly pier or wharves at which ships berth while loading or unloading cargo. So piers or wharves, basically those harbor elements where the loading or unloading of cargo is being done. So these are the platforms on which the cargo is being loaded or unloaded. In detail we will be studying when the time arrives. Transit shed, that is specifically, it is sort of, we can say, a space where the goods are stored temporarily. So transit shed and other storage areas, that is for storage of cargo or commodities where ships may discharge the incoming cargo. So that is for storing of cargo or commodity. Again, we are discussing about the terminal facilities which are being provided at a port which do not exist in the harbor. Warehouse, that is basically, warehouse is that area where the cargo or commodity are stored for a long duration. Transit shed is for short duration and warehouse is for long duration. So where goods may be stored for longer periods. The port is served by a good communication system consisting of rail routes. Now at whichever port, the amount of cargo or commodity to be handled are huge in amount, are in bulk, then the rail connection facilities provided, that is from the port itself, the cargo or commodity can be transferred to the location where it is needed. So at the port which are functioning at higher level, where higher amount or more amount of cargo or commodity are being handled, there the rail connection is provided for transfer of cargo or commodity from harbor to the railway and from through rail to the specific location where they are needed. Highway or inland waterway connections may also be provided, that is sometimes road connection might also be provided for discharge of cargo or commodity, or inland waterway connections, that is we discussed about this point in the last session. That is, inland waterway connections basically means those waterway connections which exist in the same territory, in the same country. So some small waterway connections, that is inland waterway connections, might also be used for transfer of those cargo or commodities. A port is a place which regularly provides accommodation for transfer of cargo and passengers to and from ships. So basically it provides space for transfer from ship to the ship of cargo or commodities and passengers as well. Next, talking about some salient features related to harbor and port. A port can be basically considered to have three various parts. So first is the harbor itself, which provides the appropriate channel, that is the adequate space for movement and adequate shelter for carrying out the loading and unloading work of cargo. Second are the waterfront facilities, that is facilities which are existing adjacent or on the water, such as pier and wharves, that is the, as we studied in the previous slide, that the platforms which are provided for loading and unloading of cargo. Warehouse, that is for long term storage of cargo or commodity. Fuel, that is for fueling operation. And ship supplies, that is for any maintenance work related to the ship or the repair work related to the ship. and facilities for handling cargo and passengers. So whatever facilities needed for handling the cargo or commodity and passengers are provided at the port. Floating equipments, that is, which are floating in the water body itself in harbor, such as tanks for towing ships to and from the berth. That is a sort of chain exists between the floating equipment and the ship. That is, the ship is tied up to the floating equipment at the time of berthing. So basically, the floating equipments can be of various types. We'll be studying in detail in the upcoming chapter. But as of now, for the simple purpose, that is for tying up the ship, for giving it accommodation in the harbor. The floating cranes for handling cargo and firefighting boats, that is existing firefighting boats, and sort of for handling cargo, there might be existence of cranes as well. So these are, we can say, the various bifurcations, that is, a port can be considered to have these various parts. First is the facility of the harbor, then next is the loading and unloading facility, storage facility, repair maintenance facility for loading and unloading of cargo and passenger as well. Floating equipments, that is for giving berth, for the machineries which are to be used for handling cargo. So all these various features are included in a port. Port is made up by the harbor, waterfront, railway highway or inland waterway, as I explained in the previous slide, that is the communication facilities and other supplementary or any additional services. So basically, a port includes all the facilities of the harbor, the various facilities or operations we discussed in the previous slide. Storage facility, that is transit shed and warehouse, that is for temporary storage or long-term storage. Communication facilities includes the railway, highway or inland waterway connections, that is the facilities through which the cargo which is being discharged at the harbor is being sent to the location where it is needed. And last are the terminal facilities, that is the pier or wharves, where the loading and unloading of cargo can be done. So these are the various compartments in a part. It includes all the facilities of harbor, plus the additional facilities are for storage, for communication, and the various terminal facilities. So every port is a harbor, but not any harbor is a port, because all the facilities of the harbor are included in port, but all the facilities of port are not included in the harbor. So as I previously told, that harbor is a subset of port. The port is under the state government and the harbor is under the central government. That is, the functioning or the operation of port is being handled by the state government and of the harbor by the central government.